Hey guys, I am on Heroes Heart's website right now, one of my favorite websites for tier lists. Now there's a variety of websites for tier lists. You can recommend your favorite in the comments below. This is not a sponsored video. It's just my personal preference. Now their tier list thing's a little buggy. It's still in beta, and that's perfectly fine. I just feel like I like this one because it's visually nice. But I hate tier lists. Why do I hate tier lists? Well, the major reason, there's two huge reasons why I hate tier lists. And if these two reasons are fixed, I think it's perfectly fine. I think tier lists are good, and I think it's great for you to make a tier list. But if you don't work around these two reasons why I don't like tier lists, you're kind of adding to the problem. So a lot of times I see people, they'll link a tier list from fan, and fan will have this tier list that says, these are the heroes I think are the best. And then, but it won't say, is this the best in HGC? Is this the best in Hero League? Is this the best in Silver Rank? Is this the best in NGS? Is this the best in whatever? So that's the first major problem I have with tier lists, is tier lists that don't have a purpose. So let's talk about this for example. Let's go into tacos, right? What is this tier list, right? Workhorse, we all know Workhorse. What did he make this tier list for? It just says tacos, it has no purpose here, and it doesn't explain why he likes these heroes. Are these just his favorite heroes? Is this a meme list that I just don't understand the memes for? Not putting Deckard in tier one? Like, what is this? Maybe this is just the heroes that he likes. We don't know. So if someone links me this tier list and says, well, Workhorse says that DeHawk is tier 1 and Deckard isn't even in his top 2 tiers, that doesn't tell me anything, because this could just be a tier list he made to test out or to make a video on how to make tier lists on Heroes Hearth. You know what I mean? So you need to make sure that if you're linking a tier list or building a tier list, you have a purpose for your tier lists, okay? That's the number one thing. You need to have a purpose. So I'm going to show you an example of what I consider a great tier list by going down to Professor Bobo. Professor Bobo made a tier list called Competitive and Team Play Tier List. He has a purpose. Then at each area, he has explanations of those areas. And then finally, he has some humor added to it as well. You go down to tier 5 and he says, look, if you want to pick him, I'm not going to stop you. But it's just funny. So whether I agree or disagree with his tier list, which there's several picks that I disagree with, I still think that this is a great tier list because it has a purpose to it. Now, what's the second thing that bothers me about tier lists is people making tier lists outside of their realm of credibility. What does that mean? Well, for example, Professor Bobo makes this tier list and he says, competitive and team play tier list. He is literally one of the most common casters for NGS, which means that every day he's watching competitive and team play gameplay. Literally. So he is the most credible person for the tier list that he made. But if you see someone who never watches HGC, who never watches competitive play, and brings out a tier list that says HGC tier list, that is not very credible. You want to make sure that you're credible in your area. So say, for instance, you say, oh, the best heroes in Hero League, and you're in bronze or silver. The reason why that might be hard to watch and read is because you don't really have the credibility of experiencing platinum or diamond. However, if you moved up from bronze to gold and you said the best heroes for moving out of bronze and silver, you are absolutely the most credible person for that tier list. You gave a purpose for that tier list and you were extremely credible because you did exactly what your tier list says that it's supposed to do. So having a credibility for tier list is my second most important thing. So number one, have a purpose for your tier list. Number two, be credible about your tier list. And number three, this is kind of a mini thing, but add information about your tier list. So we're going to go back to the tier lists, and I'm going to show the most recent tier list that I made, and I'm going to explain what I mean about this. So to start off, I have credibility. I watch a lot of HEC. I coach HEC teams as well as open division teams. I've worked with many of these teams. And so I have credibility in this area. The next thing that I do is I give a purpose. Now, I can't change my title because of a small bug. I'll be able to change it later. It's being fixed. I've already talked to AGG about it. Heroes Hearth about it. But this is what I do. I say, this is a tier list for competitive play at high level. This means AGC, Open Division, and the high tiers of Heroes Lounge and NGS. So I give a purpose for the tier list. Then, this is the extra little area. I give some credibility by explaining. I spend a lot of time watching this, HEC, as well as I've been pretty good at predictions in the past. Here's where I like to add extras. I pull hot statistics from Master League and revealed statistics from HEC standings. And I add to it. For example, whenever there is a controversial pick in one of my tier lists, I like to explain why. So I'm going to go down to my tier 4. And you might see that I have Stukov and Whitemane here, as well as a variety of other heroes that are picked a lot in pro play. And you're going to go, well, wait a second, Paradox. Why do you have these as tier 4? Because I'm using statistics to answer my controversial picks. Move Stukov down. Since his last balance changes on him, his win rate is 35%. I've set Whitemane in here as a 37% win rate with a decent popularity. I've moved Illidan up because it has a high win rate. I've moved Greymane down because of his low win rate. I've moved KT down because of his low win rate. So I explain that just because they're played a lot in HGC, the win rates is why I'm moving people up or down. The impact that they're bringing to games is why I'm moving them up or down. I'm seeing that there's some that are a little bit tricky, as a lot of the high-ranked teams are sneaking out Deckard first, which could be inflating his win rate a little bit and moving White Manes and Malfurions down. However, this is how I'm making the tier list. Now, I'm not going to say go to my tier list because that's the only tier list out there. What I'm saying is this. If you want to make a tier list, have a purpose, have credibility in that purpose, and give information to explain your controversial picks. That's the first major three things. And if you're going to link a tier list, make sure that you're linking a tier list from 1, someone with credibility, 2, some tier list that actually has a purpose, and 3, preferably, if you're going to have a discussion about a tier list, make sure that they have some sort of rhyme or reason for their tier list. Because those are the three major things that cause me to really despise tier lists, is when people just make tier lists willy-nilly and they don't solve those three things. There goes my rant for the day, and hopefully it's encouraged you guys to go out, make your own tier lists, because I personally like when tier... That's my thing, is I dislike tier lists in general because people keep messing up on those three things. But if you hit those 3 points, I love tier lists. I love to see really creative tier lists too, where people grab a tier list and they say, hey, this is specifically for silver, or this is specifically, I just messed that word up horribly, specifically for NGS in the blank division. That's what I love to see, is these really niche tier lists that hit a very specific thing. Overall tier lists that you just say these heroes are best at everything, I feel like don't help at all. But if you can fit your tier list into a niche that really helps people improve, that's what I love. Anyways, guys, if you like this video and you want to check out the HEC tier list that I made, I will put the link in the description below. If you'd like to follow me or any of your favorite pro players on Heroes Hearth, again, this is not a sponsored video. The website's pretty cool. You can go to mine and see any of the tier lists that I've made, but make sure to read my notes, as I have a variety of tier lists that have very specific purposes, including a tier list that just recommends heroes for new players to buy, in my opinion, because either they're easy to play or they teach good habits. Pretty much that. Either way, feel free to check out anything and go out there and make a tier list. I really want to see some cool tier lists from people that are very niche, that are unique, not just the same, oh, these are the best heroes. I want to see some cool stuff. Either way, thank you again for watching, and feel free to check out all of my other stuff. Thank you.